Hi, I'm Dave, and today we're going to work to answer the question, or at least delve into the question, how big of an air conditioner do I need? And the question is a little bit ambiguous because do you want a new unit for your old house, or do you want to just come up with a different unit for a space that's hot? If you're looking at if you're saying, oh, my house is always warm all over, the challenge with going from, say, a 3-ton unit to a 4-ton unit or something is you're going to have a lot more airflow coming in through that unit, and it's your ductwork size such that it can accommodate an extra 33% air, okay? Assuming you can get past that hurdle, the unit's gonna be cycling on and off a lot more. Why? Because it's bigger now, so it's gonna reach set point a lot faster. So if you come home and it's, say, 80 degrees, you want it to be 75 degrees, you turn on your air conditioner, it's going to get to that set point in a hurry, but then it's going to probably actually pass that set point, jolt past it to 71, 72 degrees, and then it's going to sit around until it's 78 degrees again, and then it's going to bolt back on. And every time it bolts back on, it's very inefficient energy-wise to have that surge or inrush current, A, and B, you're going to be very uncomfortable because you're going to go from being too hot and too cold. So if you're looking at just for a space like this space, there are a lot of factors that are taken into account. And let's look at those R factors. So different materials have different what's called R or resistant factors. You see that copper, second one down, is 0.37 times 10 to the minus 4. So it's 0.000037, so it's basically a perfect conductor. Fiberglass bats, 3.6. Brick like this, where we are right now, is only 0.11. And so right now it's 107 degrees out here in Las Vegas. And sun's going down, it's 6:45. But this wall right here, it's brick, it's 97 degrees, okay? And these fiberglass bats, again, they were 3.5, and that's per inch of insulation. You'll see that this is R19, so that's, you know, there's six and a half inch bats, so it's about 3 times 6 is, you know, a little bit more than R19, but you get the idea. So but, you know, when the roof is probably 130 degrees here right now, it's you're fighting quite a battle. And so could I put in another inch of some type of foam insulation here and layer of drywall? Yeah, I'll get around to that. Similar to this light here, it's hot. You know, 145 degrees. I like the light, but maybe I don't like it. You know, it's a good heater in the winter, so I'll keep it around just for that purpose maybe. But one of these days I'll put LED in here, maybe after the winter. But so what you can do too is you can get all your materials together and do what's called a load calculation. So if anyone's actually done this for their house or the space that they're trying to cool, let me know maybe in the comment section. But this is a freebie here. It's kind of cool because it starts out asking you where you're located. So if you're in Palm Springs or Las Vegas, you're lower humidity, but a lot more, got the old Mike Pence fly line around here, but you're gonna need a lot more cooling than you would in, say, San Diego. All right, so all that, one fly in the place, it has to be right on me. So take that into account. The other potential trick or recommendation here is get yourself a variable speed mini split. And why is that? Because if you're a little bit off in your calculation and your unit, and you get, say, a 1.5 ton unit for here, even though it's 300 square foot, since it's variable speed, it will only run at 8,000 or 9,000 BTU, and in that way, you won't be too hot or too cold. It's always going to be focused on your set point, okay? And So check in a mini split. You see what was in here before was, see this pipe right here? That is from a portable unit. It ducted the air out to the attic. Wouldn't recommend it. And it, there's a lot of videos why those are not recommended, but basically you're taking all the hot air and pushing it into the attic, which is fine, but what fills the space after that? Well, the air becomes negatively, the room becomes negatively pressurized, and so then the air comes right back out of the attic and it comes right back in, unless you get what's called a two-pipe unit. But in that case, anyway, just get a mini split and get proper fly protection too. Thank you. And for videos similar to this related to air conditioning, including solar powered air conditioning, go to Airspool or become a subscriber at Airspool, appropriately called Airspool. Check out airspool.com too. Thank you.